Everyone, it's Joyel, and welcome back to my channel. So, for today's video, I don't think I'm gonna do really much of an intro. If you've kept up with my community posts, you guys know that I kind of spoke about how, and what I've mentioned in previous videos, is that, you know, I do struggle with depression and anxiety every once in a while, and I asked if you guys would be interested in a video where I show you basically how I detangle my hair after a depressive episode. After you guys showed some interest in that, I figured I would go ahead and, you know, provide that video for you in hopes that I can help somebody else who is kind of going through the same thing, which is, you know, dealing with depression while also being on their natural hair journey and how to care for it after, again, you know, an episode. Like I said, I think I'm just gonna try and just get into today's video. I'm about, I want to say, a day or two out from my most recent episode, meaning that, you know, I was able to get out of bed today and I was able to eat today, but I don't have the energy to actually physically wash my hair. This is what my hair looks like right now. It's actually very dry right now, and it's kind of fluffed out because my mom was kind enough to give me a free head rub and head scratch earlier today, and so it's a little bit fluffed out, but it's very dry, and it's a little more matted towards the back right now, especially down closer to my roots. And so for today, I'm just going to show you what I kind of do to kind of get through the detangledness, because the last thing I want, again, is my hair to start naturally locking on itself, and also to prevent any matting and any extra knots. So this is what I have with me, is I have some hair ties. Some of them are snappy ties, some of them are regular. You can just kind of use what you have. I have my Felicia Leatherwood brush. For some of it, I'm gonna be doing mostly like finger detangling, and then after product is put in it, I am going to gently just kind of use my Felicia Leatherwood brush, because again, the rows split and are able to separate, which prevents like any unnecessary nagging or pulling for any of those matted or knotted up sections. I'm gonna use just a spray bottle to moisten my hair, because again, you don't wanna work on dry hair. When you have kinky, coily, afro-textured hair, you don't want to work on dry hair. You want to use something like a spray bottle to help moisturize your hair as you go. And then I just grabbed this. This is the only kind of like a leave-in butter that I have, but it's the Mielle Moisture RX Hawaiian Ginger Moisturizing Hair Butter. And this is also really good if you need something a little heavier than just a leave-in conditioner. This is really good if you don't want to top your hair with like an extra, like any extra product, like another butter or an oil. And then for my scalp, I just have some sulfur 8 that I'm going to put on my scalp, because I tend to, if I can kind of get some footage here, if you guys are kind of disturbed by like certain skin conditions or scabbing or grossed out by dandruff, you can definitely click off right now. But I do suffer from random, I want to say maybe it's eczema, because that does run on my dad's side of the family, that I get some really itchy spots, usually just along the very front of my head. It might be a little hard to see where it's dry and flaky here and itchy. That I have some kind of like scabs that are on my scalp, and that usually goes away after using my dandruff shampoos and stuff like that. But just for today, you know, I'm trying to keep it real simple. Today's mostly about detangling. I will get to a wash day video. Sorry, I'll get to a wash day video in another, you know, in another time. But today is mostly just about the detangling, because most of the time, I don't have the energy to go through a full wash day. So my biggest concern is re-moisturizing my hair and sectioning it out to get it detangled. So I usually just use plain water. If you want to kind of kill two birds with one stone, or make the detangling process even more easier for yourself, especially if your matting or your knots are a bit more intense than mine, I actually suggest mixing your leave-in conditioner or your cream butter in with your water and shaking it up, because it's gonna add an extra softening effect. to it. For me right now, my hair was already previously kind of stretched before, you know, going into my depressive episode. And then also my mom kind of helping massage and just naturally kind of, you know, kneading and kind of help picking apart some of my hair earlier today definitely helped. But right now I'm just gonna spray it with water. Okay. Now drench it enough to where you can, you know, it doesn't feel super dry to the touch, or enough to where you can at least get your hair into some sections with your snap ties. I also hope this will help others who have, you know, definitely some length to their hair, which, you know, requires a lot more energy and work. But today I was able to get out of bed, and I have enough energy, I think, to be able to do this. So now that I have my hair, you know, pretty damp, so now I'm gonna kind of just massage some of that water so it's not as drippy. Oh wow, you can see my red undertones a bit right at the top here. You guys can kind of see, it's pretty sick. But just, we're gonna do some big sections. Again, this isn't meant to be like a hairstyle per se. Let me turn around so you guys can kind of see. And I'm just gonna go through and use my fingers, kind of massaging that water through so that I can separate my hair in half at first, but also not tear my, yeah, here's a knot right here. Okay. So I really hope I was able to catch that, but here's my hair in one half. These don't have to be perfect whatsoever. I just got one half put away, and what I'm gonna do now is I'm probably gonna do about four sections on each side. So here's the front, and you can spray more water as you go as necessary. One. And then this last piece I'm going to split in half. Okay, so I have four, and I'm just gonna do the same thing with the other side of my head now. Okay, so I have my four sections. I might actually make this one a little smaller just because it's the thickest part of my head and I just don't really wanna mess with that a whole ton. Okay, so I have four sections on each head, and now what I'm going to do is initially I'm going to take my sulfur 8 and just put it on the parts. I'm gonna go ahead and take my sulfur 8 and just apply it to the parts of my scalp that I can currently see. Bright enough, you guys can see what I'm doing. I'm filming this at night, which I usually don't do. Making sure to really get your patchy pieces or whatever's itching for you. Mine is gonna be right along my edge here. Now that that's pretty much greased up, just to keep this easy, I have an alligator clip. I think that's what it's called, a crocodile clip, alligator clip. I'm gonna take my first section out here, re-wet it. I'm kind of spraying my scalp too because it feels really good. That's just me. You don't have to if you don't want to. I'm mostly gonna drench my ends. And now I'm gonna take a scoop of my moisture butter here. I'm gonna use a pretty big size because my hair's pretty dry. I basically haven't touched my hair since Halloween. And you can add more if you need to. Whatever's gonna help you just get through your hair. I suggest kind of going through and separating it with your fingers first, if you can, if you have the energy to. I just grabbed another smaller dollop, and I'm just gonna spread it down like this. Okay. Now I'm gonna take my Felicia Leatherwood brush, and I'm just gonna start at the ends, and I'm just going real soft. Brushing my hair with the Felicia Leatherwood brush, or just like brushing your hair in general, reminds me a little bit of that experiment they would have you do in school with the water and the cornstarch. The slower you move, the easier you're gonna get through. The faster you try to go, you're gonna get snugged and, you know, run into some knotted obstacles there. But the slower you go, the easier time you're gonna have getting through your hair and not ripping. And I also see going slow, you're kind of like not, at least for me, it's not as tiring as just trying to like get through your hair. So just go a decent pace, you know, be gentle with yourself. You've had a rough couple of days already, so. For me, this is about 4 days of just laying on my hair. Not all of those days did I have a bonnet. You know, and don't be ashamed of, you know, talking about your depression or, you know, explaining or, you know, taking this extra time to have to dedicate or taking this time to dedicate to your hair because you've, you know, been dealing with something else on top of, you know, trying to be on a journey of self-love or your natural hair journey. You know, depression and anxiety have been something that now, I'm just gonna take it in half and I'm just going to do two big twists here. And if you want, you can just band. I usually start from the bottom and it will go up. It takes me about 2 bands to do that. Or you can twist it around into a little bun and leave it that way as well. It's totally up to you. I think today I'm gonna do buns. Sorry. I'm just gonna refix that. But what was I saying? Actually, I'm gonna do twist. Twist might be a little easier to lay on even underneath your bonnet, which you can just slip on and off. But depression and anxiety are things that I have kind of always, not always, it really started for me in high school after a lot of my bullying and whatnot. And also just being a highly sensitive person. But I know that oftentimes speaking about mental health, especially in the Black community, is can be seen as a bit taboo. It can be seen as a bit taboo. But I'm not here to judge on my channel. You know, sometimes your natural hair journey involves or will become intertwined with other journeys, such as, you know, mental health journey or your physical health journey or, you know, emotional health journey and, you know, so on and so forth. But I do believe in fighting the stigma by speaking about it and being open about it. And just so you know, I have done counseling for it. I actually did counseling through BetterHealth. This isn't sponsored. I'm just being dead honest. The reason I chose BetterHealth is because it was online and I had an easier way of getting to decide who I wanted my therapist or counselor to be. And I specifically wanted a female, Black female counselor, because I figured out of there, or at least biracial, at least Black or biracial. And I happened to find a very, very kind, very understanding Black female counselor. And the reason I did that is because who was going to better understand, you know, a lot of the things that I've been through? And, you know, no offense to anyone else out there, but I just didn't think that, you know, a white woman or a man would be able to understand certain struggles or obstacles that I've gone through in my life. And I also got to pick a counselor who specialized in anxiety, depression, and eating disorders and, you know, things of that sort. And the only reason I stopped doing the counseling, I have all written down the different behavioral health techniques that she showed me for dealing with my anxiety. I have those written down, but it just became expensive for me during this time. But I also do see a family doctor who is also, I believe she's mixed, but she is mixed with Black, so she is a Black biracial female doctor who I see for, who prescribes my medicine for me for my anxiety. And those of you who are just interested in knowing, I I take Venlafaxine. I'll put it in the video and maybe in the description box below for those that are interested in the medication I take to help manage my anxiety and stuff. And I see her every couple of months. My next appointment with her is in January. And she's really awesome. She knows about my YouTube channel and stuff. I really like her. But I don't think we should be, as hard as it is, and I know it's hard that not everybody understands mental health. I'm just taking some sulfurate on some other spots real quick, but I know that not everybody is going to understand or be able to empathize with you when it comes to your mental health struggles. But I want you to know that my channel is very open and honest, and I don't judge anybody because I understand what that's like. You know, I'm not a perfect human being. I haven't had, you know, a perfect life. No one has. I don't believe in putting on a fake facade, you know, but I also don't do this to be depressing. I do this to be open and to hope that my struggles and experiences will help other people. It kind of makes the struggles worth it, if that makes sense. It's also nice to know that, you know, you're not alone with how you feel or what you're experiencing. And not every day is a bad day. You know, I think right now I've kind of been back to back with my episodes just because I am going through a rough, you know, time of my life right now with, you know, the ending of relationships, a relationship, and, you know, changing my entire environment. I'm not gonna say even just dealing with, like, certain YouTube comments, because I honestly don't get that many, like, really bad comments, to be honest with you. And most of the time it does, like, I don't mind explaining myself either, but most of the time they don't bother me because, you know, there's just a certain level of ignorance that you can't take seriously. So the comments don't really bug me a whole lot. There's some where it's like, dang, that was harsh, but besides that, not really. But, this is a tough section, so I'm gonna have to go really slow. If it's easier for you to do it in smaller sections, by all means. Like, if you need to separate out a section to detangle it and then you can include it into a bigger section when it comes time to twisting, by all means. You know, everyone's hair is pretty different. But again, luckily, I had already kind of stretched my hair after rinsing out all the hair waxes from the Halloween costumes. And then that's, after that is when I kind of just stopped doing anything with my hair these last couple of days. But, Also, if you want to use this time to use like any growth oils, like such as the castor oil or, you know, an oil of your choice on your scalp, I would suggest that too, especially if you haven't been sleeping with a bonnet to help prevent any breakage. I've only gone maybe 2 nights without my bonnet, so I think I'm doing okay. I've got enough hair. I mean, if I lost a whole puff, I don't think my hair would suffer much, but, but at least this way, if, you know, sometimes, you know, I will get the energy back a day or two and then go back into the, or like kind of finish out the episode in another day or two, but at least I know that my hair has been put away. And then once the episode is completely gone or I'm, you know, feeling much more back to normal, then I will do my wash day routine in order to, you know, help cleanse my hair and my scalp and get myself kind of back on track there. But my parents are very supportive with my mental health. You know, it's something that runs in the family, so, you know, luckily I have a pretty good support system when it comes to when I'm having those moments and things. And, you know, oftentimes I don't know what triggers certain episodes or my depression. Sometimes it just hits you. You know, one day you're feeling great and you're feeling like you can accomplish anything and, you know, nothing can get you down, or you're just feeling like your normal self, and then, you know, an hour later or the next day or, you know, whatever, you know, just feels like the whole world is literally sitting on top of you and you feel like there's nothing you can do, or, you know, why do you feel this way? And you know, what have you done wrong to deserve feeling that way? If you guys have seen that movie, the Fighting Temptations, I think it has like Cuba Gooding Jr., Beyonce, and like a ton of other celebrities and singers and actors in it. It's a really good movie. I mean, it's been a favorite movie of mine since I was a kid. My mom used to watch it all the time. Like, I think she even bought the soundtrack to it when it came out. But there's a song, and I think it's, what's it called? I think it's called He Still Loves Me, and it's sang by Beyonce and Walter Williams. But even as a kid, there was always the set of lyrics that she sings that always stuck with me, that really spoke to me even as a kid. I used to wake up some days and wish I'd stayed asleep, 'cause I went to bed on top of the world. Today the world's on top of me. Everybody's got opinions, but they ain't been in my position. That breaks my heart when I hear what they have to say about me. Yeah. I'm not the best singer, but those lyrics have literally always stayed with me. They mean a lot. It's something I can definitely relate to. Talking about how, you know, everybody's got an opinion, but no one's ever been through the same experiences that you have. And, you know, so I don't want you guys to ever think that, like, your mental health doesn't matter, or how what you're going through doesn't matter, because it does. The only person that knows what it's like to walk through your shoes is you. You know, don't be afraid, you know, to ask for help in, you know, either just, you know, venting or writing a journal or reaching out to, you know, hotlines. or, you know, maybe dedicating maybe even just once a month to a counselor if that's what you can afford, or, you know, trying medication. What matters is that you're trying. Now I'm done twisting and, you know, tying my hair back and, you know, detangling and re-moisturizing and stuff like that. So, but that's pretty much all that I do. This is, you know, my detangle process without the wash day again, because, you know, sometimes coming out of the depressive episode, you know, you have just enough energy to, you know, get out of bed and maybe brush your hair, but not all the strength you would have on a normal day to go through a whole wash day routine. So this is what I do to take care of my hair, and now I'm just gonna let it, you know, dry a little bit, and then I keep a bonnet by my bed most of the time. So what I'll do is then just slip my bonnet on, either when I go back to my bedroom or, you know, right when I'm about to go to sleep, and, you know, kind of just keep it under that for right now. But, you know, once you're done, you know, just, you know, give yourself kudos for taking this step in just self-care. Like, you've moisturized your hair, you've detangled, you've put it away, you know, pat yourself on the back. You've accomplished your goal, and that's something to be proud of. You know, luckily, you know, having been dealing with this as long as I have, I do know that, you know, even though the depressive episodes are some of the worst feelings you can have, and it feels like it's not gonna ever go away or end, you know, I know that I will come out of this. You know, with the lows comes the highs, with the downs comes the ups, and whether it's, you know, one day, 3 days, a week, 2 weeks, I know that eventually it will plateau off and I can begin climbing again. So that's what keeps me going. It's just knowing that, you know, hey, I just have to get through this right now, and, you know, I will do what I am capable of doing, to the best of my ability. But right now, I just need to allow myself to rest more than anything. But just know that, you know, you guys are never alone on your natural hair journey, or even dealing with your mental health journey. You're never alone. As long as I have my channel here, as long as I'm here, you're never alone. Don't be afraid to, you know, seek out help or reach out to people. As scary as it can be, one of the best decisions I made was to take that time to find my doctors and to find my counselor and learn what I needed to learn in order to help me, you know, manage my life. Again, I know that I'm very blessed to have a incredibly supportive family that understands a lot of what I am going through, and I know not everybody has that, but again, just know deep down you're never alone. If you have to email me, if you have to, you know, join a support group on Facebook or just online, you know, do it. But I'm not really going to talk about it right now, but I'll probably do a video of I have some new membership things going on, and then some other services that I'd like to offer to you guys, which involve, you know, Zoom chats, you know, personal one-on-one Zoom chats for those of you that are interested. But like I said, I'll get into those at another video. But I really hope that this does help somebody. It's not like a super extreme routine. I wanted to keep it super simple. You guys know everything I do is super simple and realistic, and I try to keep it as non-backbreaking as humanly possible, especially when you have as much hair as we do, or as I do. But again, I hope that you guys at least learned something from this video. Please don't forget, keep blooming. You're so special. And I'll see you in my next video.